Oh my God, Lil Tang, look at that country. It is so old. It looks like one of those ancient countries. But you know, who understands those ancient countries? It's only studied because it's like a total dinosaur, okay? I mean, the country, it's just so old. I can't believe it's so ancient. It's like out there. I mean, gross. Look, it's just so Chinese.
I like the Shang and I cannot lie. You other warriors can't deny that when we rule the shamanistic place with a bronze sword in your face, you get status. Wanna show who's host? Cause you worship grandpa's ghost. Oracle bones with writing. Historians use for deciphering. Zoera split into two parts. Feudalism became an art. Influenced by Confucius. Coexisted with the...
Where is he going?
Warren State's time. Qin State began to climb. Well, join me. Join me. Cause I'm the founder of Qin Shi Huangdi. I've seen the Shang Nu. To hell with the Shang. So build. Hall. Forced labor helped make the Great Wall. Difference is confusing. So I standardized all things. But Han Fei's legalism had no slack. Them peasants fought back. So peasants.
Yeah.
Peasants.
Yeah.
Has your emperor made you mad?
Hell yeah.
Tell him chill out.
Chill out.
Chill out.
Chill out.
Overthrow him now. Peasants fight back.
Liu Bang won and started the Han. Liu Bang won and started the Han.
He spoke against the Qin. What he actually did, he kept the old Qin laws, he fixed the economy. Now here's old Wu Di, gave the emperor power, and fought the Shang Nu, fought. Confucianism everywhere, and the scholar gentry got lots of care. And Buddhism arrived and outspread, was growing like a bubble. The Han's in trouble, everyone saying uh-oh. It was the first time in a while, but this way united them all with style. For the Grand Canal, yo, leaking Yangtze to the yellow.
A word about a Tang Empire had roads to admire and Buddhist desires. Tributary states to Shou Chang An was a center till Tang growth slowed down. Buddhism's influence broke down. After Tang fell came the Song with their junk wows and gun pals made new philosophies. Printing press, compass, use tax farming express. So ladies,
yeah!
Ladies,
yeah!
Are your feet bleeding out Euphrates? Leave the Song. Kublai Khan, the Mongol is coming out strong. Merchants get slack. Beijing in whack. Yeah, China. When it comes to Mongols, China can't do nothing about their invasion. 1368 CE? Haha, that's when Ming came. So Hongwu moves to Nanjing, but Yongle stays in Beijing, and Zheng He travels around the world searching tripping for Ming. The Ming Empire closed its doors, no one explores its shores. Replaced paper, used silver, and porcelain trade grew bigger. Some Manchus want to rule the Han class, Brits sell you that opium, mask, but you bought it, and trash it. So the Brits came back and sacked them, and Britain took Hong Kong, and the Qing had to play along. His internal strife was alive and kicking, with the Taiping rebellion.
To the Kuomintang that toppled the Qing, Sun Yat-sen rising. Then he sprung the Kuomintang, which was toppled by Mao Zedong. The chairman's 5-year plan was muddled off the Russians. His great leap forward was a bust, left his economy in the dust. So China, if you wonder why your economy is second in line, that 1-900 Mao Zedong, but dang with the econ strong, China on track. China on track.